Good morning. Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's coming up on 07 hours UTC, 08 hours CET, and about 09 hours Eastern European time. Coming up on 02 hours Eastern Standard Time here in the United States. It's the 24 hours of Kiering Grand Prix Long, coming up on the completion of the 16th hour. And 24 hours is at 1 second per second, as it were, drawing towards its inevitable conclusion. Dominic Engel and Jonathan Palm with you. And Dom, it's quite a down a lot lately from the first few hours of this race.
It's calmed down so much, actually, it's probably more effective than sleeping pills right now. Especially compared to the first 6 hours, because those were, well, insane, quite frankly. We've had overtakes and punctures and crashes and bad luck and overtakes and punctures and crashes and bad luck and overtakes and punctures and crashes and bad luck and more bad. And ever since, been getting more spread out. Mistakes have... well, there are fewer mistakes now. Than earlier in the race. Now, I think we have a battle between Elton Chong for Ixion Sim Sports Pro and Robin Heidgeman. They're both on different parts of the stint, but, well, Chong thinks that he should be past that guy, nevertheless.
It makes a nice feeling when you get past.
Well, not always. Nogiech back in the Tomcat racing car, so expect him to break the fastest lap 20 times over, or at least trying to.
The Infiniti Esports Pro car is timed out a long time ago. They are currently running about 39-40 laps behind.
There goes Song. So, oh, side by side. And we're not getting caught up in that lag. Here we go. Chomp through for a moment at least. Seemingly able to hold down away on the straight due to a bit of a better exit out of last turn. Isn't it how much he can gain from that, because, well, the time left in this stint isn't too great.
Fifteen hours and 56 minutes gone. Leader remains NX Racing after a interesting start to the race, let's say it that way, Dom. I think that's the safest way to say their first couple of...
I'm pretty sure they didn't see coming what happened to them. And it took them quite a while to get back up to where they are now. I mean, they've had a problem initially, down to 12th, with the wheel problems off in Javi, and then the drive-through they had to serve due to those wheel problems. And ever since after, well, 5 hours after that, every time they were very close to getting the lead again, something's happened to them, but ever since, they've been pretty much fine. And are now runner leaders.
The last appearance of the safety car was at the 7 hour 40 minute mark. So we have only had two.
Yeah, I thought we had. I completely forgot about the second one. Oh well.
Mm. first one was at the 4 hour and 25 minute mark. That was for a car slightly in the gravel in a slightly dodgy position.
And the second one was for a car slightly being upside down in a even dodgier
position. So, yeah, and that, we went back green from that last safety car deployment at 22:52:15 UTC, so that's about 7 hours, 51 minutes, 55 seconds race time.
Also, it's worth mentioning so, that long-time leader of the M-Class, HRT, Hellenic Racing Team and the FX, have just lost their lead again due to the pit stop they've just made. And the driver change, and now the stick breeding program with Jackie at the moment behind the wheel are in very much in the lead of our category.
Isaac Price coming across the main straight now to complete his 417th lap, 15:59:09 race time, and here in just under 1 minute then we will cross the two-thirds distance of this race. Which, according to my best guess, there's about 217 laps remaining if we stay green all the way.
Somewhat over 200, because then it's not going to be wrong. More than one, because then it's never ever going to be wrong. Yes, turning out here very much endurance-like endurance race.
Yes. Yeah, I think there was a lot of concern that safety cars would ruin that and just turn it into a series of sprint races, but
I think the wave arounds, or rather the lack of wave arounds helped that a lot. So it made it very interesting.
Marcus Schneider is connecting to take over the
And I think his father, he's the fastest driver in that car.
Completing an average of 26 1/8 laps per hour at this rate. But I think the average fully green flag stint length is 27 laps.
You gotta calculate the stop as well. So technically, if you do 26 and you have a massively long pit stop, which usually you do, it's basically almost an hour. We are past 6 hours. Yeah. Two-thirds gone. Only one-third left. Only two IGTC the race left. See, I've just noticed we're running No, actually, I'm lying already. I was gonna say we're running the whole IGTC season race length in this race with the hours, which is wrong, because 4 times 8 is not 24, it's 32, and I fail at maths.
A wild Phil Diaz.
Hello? Hello.
Welcome in, Mr. Fildy. You haven't missed much. You just missed the entire race.
You missed a bit. That was actually a race. Now it's just cars driving around.
That's the most exciting part.
NX tried to make it interesting. Maddie got a drive-through on his first pit stop and made Isaac have to clean up.
That was 15 hours ago.
Yes. I took the month over 5 in back.
Wow, am I really seeing an FXR 9th?
Yes! Very much so. Actually, not really, because I think then 30 according to the track.
Oh, timeouts, yes.
Very much so. They actually led the M class for, I think, half the race. Not half the race, let's say, a couple of hours for sure. Just because they magically managed to almost gain a full lap on everyone behind them under the safety cars.
Wow. Wave around.
There are no waves.
I know, that's the joke.
They did not get waves.
Charm's coming in to pick.
Got Elton Chung in the pit lane.
Just notice his front end is curved, or at least appears to be. Not like it does anything aerodynamic, so.
So Phil.
Sadeco.
Guess how many safety cars were avoided by hot rescue of cars stuck in gravel?
Oh, I'm hoping at least 3.
4 or 5 is le correct mundo answer.
That's good.
They're like 4 within a 40-minute window.
Where people just having fun. In the first hour. I was gonna say, were people just having fun punting others off or something?
Very much. The most fun being punted off and off in general was given to Byrazam, because they had an off due to wheel issues, lost 2.5 minutes, then got out, then drove down through the last corner, onto the south finish straight, then down the straight, and got punted off into the next gravel trap and lost another 2.5 minutes. Basically, they lost,
by the way,
almost 3 laps in the third of a lap.
Oh my.
If you want to catch up on your viewing, the first 8 hours are on the NDR YouTube channel already. Like a ball.
Very
you can
nice.
Watch both. You can watch the live stream and the on demand recording at once if you want to completely confuse yourself.
I was already. Killed my phone battery watching the tracker quite a little bit of the day. Whenever I had time. It's good enough, I think.
seemingly, that if you give some belief to the tracker, the smallest gap we have currently on track is 22 under half seconds. Yay. Which is not true, because I don't know about that 10 second gap lower down between LLM Amateur and Scuderia Gas.
Sixth and seventh are probably about 10 seconds apart.
Yeah, they're rough 12 apart from what I can see. But then again, I think they might be on different parts of their stint. Or not. Yeah, Cole has already been out on track for a couple of laps longer. Those tires are already wearing nicely. Whereas Taskinen even has just left the pits.
Imar has gone off at the exit of the Bluthy Chicane.
Oh yeah, very much so, actually. Pushing it. Wow, he had a very fast seconds left for that stage of the stint. It's not going to help him on this lap. The tyres seem to be in reasonable shape, so no worries for a puncture or slidey action. Stick braking program pro in the pits, that should give 4th place for now at least to the 10 of Genuine Racing. Gagavitz and the car, off they go.
Have they been breeding well this race?
They seem to have bred us a couple of stakes because they're doing quite well.
I was just wondering because their rear end was smashed in quite a bit.
I think that's been like that for quite a while, actually. Not sure where they got it, could have been anywhere.
core's not too far behind them.
You mean the 09?
Yes.
They're still on kind of recovery drive after. I think they had a puncture and actually got stuck and lost quite a bit of time very early on in the race. When everyone decided to get punctures and do silly mistakes and be very unlucky.
I'm guessing it was the start of the night. Start of the night when that started happening?
No, that was at the very start of the race. Nothing's happened ever since the safety car. Nothing, maybe a bit.
Boost the chicane?
I can't really remember anything big. Except for maybe a few spins. Been too long already this race.
Well, it is 24 hours. And I don't think he should be saying that.
If you're still wanting a permanent haircut there.
Oh, he's stuck in the sand.
Is he? Where is he now? Oh, he's stuck. Actually, enough. What, he should get out there with Mount.
Phil, I'm on.
Okay.
Pushed down in absolutely no time. If everything goes according to plan, which will be our quadrillion avoided safety car so far. So I get that done. A rough push for you, Scylla, but well, doesn't matter, he's out anyways. Out is out. He's going after losing considerable amount of time, nevertheless, though. Surprised he didn't get out on his own. Not sure if he tried the mouse option. Doesn't seem like it, though, because I see no updated control messages in the chat log. And in the same travel trap 55 just had a bit of an excursion and Kaliki! It's avoiding him in the grass when he's got all the width of the track on the left side. That's a bit interesting.
Isaac Prey spinning now.
Thank you.
there's a yellow flag sweeper. A 14 Colt Probe 1 car seems to have had a bit of an off there. Also a bit of damage to it's actually quite a bit of damage, to be honest, on the right hand side of that car. That could be at the worst even instant repairs needed on that. There still seems to be very stable, but there still seems to be some bit of kind of negative camber on the right hand side suspension as it's meant to be. Question is whether that be enough or handling any good.
Stuck in the sand again. I got him this time.
It's turn 4.
The 57 LLM is stuck in the gravel trap again, this time in, well, the next gravel trap down the track, actually. So you have probably some kind of control issues, or they got punted off. I mean, we already had the situation today. Best of times to happen, especially this late in the race when the time to make up for it gets smaller and smaller by the second, quite literally.
Oh great, he's up against the wall.
Good job.
Seems to have been a spin on the oval by Noggy Edge, seemingly, because he's going very slowly and there are lots of skip marks and a yellow flag.
He also has right side suspension damage now.
And the somewhat hot tyres, well, not hot tyres, but somewhat hotter tyres than you would expect them to have out there.
Oh, there's also a car from the booth of chicane there.
I don't even know who that was.
72 car.
Ah, 72, that's 6A Hondo.
Heard some things about them.
Kind of somewhat extra threat so far.
Gunselman comes into pit.
Was expected, Noggy Edge also in the pit, so he doesn't want to drive around with a bent car that's got toe damage. Both of those ops are probably not in their schedule, they're very much not in their schedule.
Second place in pro is about to pass second place in amateur.
Yeah, it shouldn't be too hard, at least if it happens on the straight. Which there are many off here, or at least flat out bits where you don't go off. But this one here, Arch Kane.
The 09 of Falk has passed the 21 stick reading program.
Pro.
Oh, that's very interesting, because they're not even that far out of sync. Colcar could probably make that up if they keep on that run with the shorter pit stops.
I'm assuming that they've had some pretty good lap times lately since they pulled away from the 07 as well.
Their fastest lap time, like good, so I presume the other ones aren't that much worse. Very decent average lap times in that car, at least.
Closest battle I can see now is the 71 and the 58. They're not exactly close. Oh, and the and not the 59. They're three laps apart. How's that possible? One position being three laps apart.
Two I'm laps not apart. Sorry, it is one position.
Going from 11th to 12th on server. It's crazy.
Yeah, it's, I thought, well, yeah, great battle, oh no, wait, they're two laps apart, and then it turned out, oh my god, they're not even directly behind each other position-wise.
Oh, yeah, it's a tracker.
Fair number of turnouts, I mean timeouts, although nothing extreme or worrying, just normal kind of timeouts as you usually get in these races.
Good morning, Herr Thilo.
Good morning!
Hello!
Welcome back. Did you have a nice sleep, Thilo?
Yeah, very nice.
Cool. I'm still wide awake.
I'm still awake, everyone. Except for those people who aren't.
I think I'm awake.
I'm not quite sure anymore.
You've missed all the stuff that's not worth caring about too much, because we're in a phase of the race where a lot is happening, if you consider the cars driving around as a lot happening.
That's normally what these races consist of.
I don't know, I thought it was probably the best.
Why is Robin Britscop floating over the track?
He's what?
Not
to me.
We have a UFO.exe thing going on. Yeah, it's supposed to save It's supposed to save tires. Reduces the tire heat because they're not touching the ground.
Exactly. I was just gonna say, you can even run super soft Pirellis over the whole race.
No.
Oh, I thought it was a new feature, the new alpha beta version of LFS that the beta testers.
Oh yes, it's exactly what it is.
Also,
it's LFS.
But the that new day-night day transitions and the new damage mod.
Yes, wings flying off. We can even have the side mirror pop off.
He also did a Toro Rosso thing where I and blow your front suspension and a braking sound like a clown car. It was like a clown car. What the hell were they doing?
Yes, it was. That's why I'm laughing so much.
But I just don't understand, because he must have been breaking before that in the lab. Why did it happen there? I still don't understand it till today. That's the only thing I remember Toro Rosso doing in the last 20 years. They were better when they were Minardi. Probably because Minardi was funny.
'55 seems to have had an issue.
They've been having very interesting lines and maneuvers recently.
I can't wonder what car is missing.
What do you mean?
Because when I went to bed, there was still 26.
Merida Racing, I suppose.
No. Cartwheel.
Infinity Esports, oh. Yeah, they're gone. They seem to have
Toth
quit.
Climbed up laps and laps ago and no one returned.
Okay.
Ultimate death of the internet is what you could call that.
So no luck for the Dindamus birthday.
Yeah, pretty much. I wonder whether he actually knows her, or whether he went to bed and left the stint to his teammates. Because if he comes back and finds out, he's probably not going to be too amused.
59 also just had a problem, same area.
Yeah, just off, I think he did a loop around or something. Good news!
Dacia Sandero!
No! Even better!
It's already available in case, so it can't be bad.
There are no protests left outstanding. Everything has been answered. So
bet you someone's gonna challenge and just gonna make one.
Well, there is one incident that I've been requested to look at to before they file a protest, just to know it's worthy of it.
It's interesting to see that Troy is using his age certificate for the scarf.
That's what he's always been doing.
Yeah. Still, it's interesting.
It's an SCR, of course he'd use his age shifter. If it was XRR, then that'd be different.
Well, it would depend. It's an old enough LFS version, you could probably use H-Shifter. Actually, think till before Y, you could use H-Shifter in pretty much all the GTRs. The gearbox is well made from, I don't know. Nothing very specific. At least, because they're not really that precise, rather random.
Isn't he streaming himself again this year or this race?
Yeah, on livestream.com/LXO as always. I've mentioned that before. I still hope the stream's going, not like earlier in the race where it decided to go. Oh well.
No, this time it's working. I'm watching over the shoulder content. Livestream.com/LXO.
Mentioning LXO, that's all been quite some time since that's happened.
LXO, what do you mean?
LX only cup, I think, is what that stream site name is about.
Correct.
It's been quite a while, and I would say at least 4 years since that's happened, if not much more. much about their like leagues because I'm not a particularly fan of those guys. Well, I gotta say the Elix are always okay. X6 I don't like so much.
Yeah. I was saying, yeah.
The last Alex figure I can remember was the one with the Alex World Championships.
I drove only three LX races in my entire LFS career. Two of them were in City League, one of them was the NDR Easter event 2011, which was the dullest race I've ever been in.
Even duller than the one with the UF1s?
The UF1s?
Yeah.
I don't know, I don't care about you.
You've won at FE3. FE4.
Oh, you mean, oh god. Nah, I think LX2 at. LX2? What does that LX2? I mean, LX4, care what I do. Is somewhat duller than that.
Okay.
LX2 would be a motorbike.
So guys, if my maths are correct,
got
which they're
maps.
Not because I don't even know the numbers in my maths, the 58 Virus Am car is catching the 71 at a rate of at least a second a lap, quite a bit more sometimes, so he'll be there within the next 5 laps.
We'll see about that. He set a PB on his left lap, so he's not going too slow. Kaliki in the virus car, I mean.
Yeah, it's a little less of damage, but nothing internal.
They've had that for a while. I'm pretty sure they've repaired it at some point, or maybe they've just been carrying that down since they've been bish-bosh-bashed about in the first part of the race.
It looks like quite a few cars here have been through war.
Yeah, I can say that.
Once again, another 9/10 of a second. And Kaliki's off.
Oh, now he's trying to adjust the right side to.
He's trying to even up the car, and he rejoined the track. Interestingly, he's all good.
He eventually rejoined it.
Now he did give the right front a little bit too much damage.
Yeah. Actually, like when lots of broken looking cars are driving around, it makes the race look bad, but it's just the way it works in LS.
As long as the upper and lower control arms rather close when it comes to damage, they have the same amount of damage, then it's not too bad. It's still horrible to drive, but it. At least you can drive them somewhat. Some contact.
Mm. Core Racing Pro putting a lap on Noggy Edge there, if I'm not wrong. Bronco's also not having enough races here again, with, well, they were leading and very high up in general early on, and now they're 9th. Couple of laps back on the desk, so yeah, certainly not going to plan.
Nah, things always happen. They can still bounce back.
If there were any red, white, and red barriers here, and we would be on a somewhat older version, they could literally do that.
Gotta do what you gotta do sometimes.
And then they would throw your wrist rolling over.
Guess I should actually look at the tracker when it comes to cars on track.
According to the track, the smallest gap is the 1-4. Fifth between Core and Stick Breeding Program. Wrong. Which I probably am. Yeah.
8 seconds.
No, it's not. Virus gap, but Scuderia Cat is obviously smaller.
Well, no, because the virus car went off, so.
Guess I should press F5, which is not going to change a thing. The track is not going to refresh anyways, even if I do that.
Did something just happen? Why is Hydraman suddenly behind the 21 and the 09? And he's passing the 21
right now.
That's
because he did. As you can see by that he's got very fresh tires.
Oh, I see that now, yes. Yes. That could be a good reason.
Now pitting usually loses you time.
Except for when you're on the code 80.
Well, if you pit on code 80, or code 60 rather, at Dubai, you still lose time because you can't refuel and change tyres because they've got the worst pit facility known to mankind.
Well, that's only for the buyer.
It actually reminds me of East Germany, where you have to queue up to get your lot. Queue up to get tyres, then queue up to get fuel.
I can't remember.
What?
I think it was the NASCAR Truck Series. They had it to where at one point you had to take tires and fuel on two different pit stops. For what reasons, I have no idea. But it was like that for a short amount of time, I believe. And they changed it back pretty instantly.
I wonder why, because that rule seems so sensible. Apparently they did this to save money. Oh, that's obviously logical. Oh, a car just went rearing into the wall. I think
correct,
virus am, yes.
Martinez.
Wow, and Martinez.
Oh.
Oh, and then Kalecki just... Oh, jeez. Almost gave 07 a heart attack.
Well, Martinez tested the brakes of a stick breathing program there.
That's someone he also gave a heart attack, is the 07 Nixion car.
Back to the battle for fifth.
Oh, Cole Racing Season 2 made its way up to the lead up again, you see.
No, they're not on a lead up because.
Okay.
Because I think, if I'm not wrong. No one but the top three is on the lead lap.
Yeah. Okay, never mind.
Oh, I just saw some contact somewhere, which is obviously. Oh, Martinez is off again!
It looked like he had some pretty bad lag at some point.
Oh god! He almost crashed into a wall there.
Once again,
that car,
21's getting ever closer to the 10 here. We have a battle, Dom. We might as well watch it.
I don't want to.
That's going to be a tough penalty.
So it's going to certainly be a penalty. A drive-through penalty, to be exact.
So, stick breeding program and your team bomb.
We're fast on stick breeding program. I'm cheering for stick breeding program now.
Always cheering for whoever I'm not cheering for.
Well, yeah, you can't cheer for the same people, that's boring.
Simplifies things, Guido.
Makes it too easy.
Don't seem quite have the pace to be able to overtake though. And especially, and they didn't have the best of last corners there.
Yeah, their right side dampers look like they've seen better days.
Well, sure, looking out of window, day seems all right. Where I live, at least.
The bleeding problem's right. Rear damper is pretty interesting. Slight wishbone damage on the front right.
I'm not sure, they probably won't repair that too soon, although they probably would gain some time from it, driving wise.
Yeah, I would say the dampers are more of a problem with the control arms right now.
The camber problems are really. They don't really mean much, but that right rear damper's kind of offset the balance in the corners quite a lot.
Oh, Hydraman! Oh,
god! Like it was in TV, I thought he was kind of careering off into the scenery.
And there we go, the bleeding program takes the position.
That Hydraman's left rear is just a little warm.
That's thanks to Origi's suspension.
Nah, suspension looks good.
But what I meant with that is the set seemingly gets affected extremely by ridiculously small amount of damage.
Gotcha. I think there is another position change on track somewhere. I couldn't tell where it was though.
On the track?
Yes, I saw two names switch, but I don't know where. Supposedly the 54 and the 14 are like 3.5 seconds apart. That's one thing.
Yes, they are. '54 is not any car, it's a leading amateur car so far in this race. After 16 hours, 4 minutes, with only 4 days remaining in the race.
Oh yeah, GPS core car should be catching quickly. Behind those two are second place overall.
Emmy and Arati coming to the lap now. Hope you won't interfere with that too much. Turn it one way or another.
This should be a rather easy pass here, I would assume.
Whoa! When he rushes out wide with through because of the draft every single corner. Unfortunately, one of the features around that section of the track.
Oh god, Rowdy!
Yeah, I don't know why he's being so ambitious right now with that. He lost more time by doing that than just waiting behind him.
He should have, even if he had gone for the gap, he should have backed that way sooner to just stay behind him.
Exactly, it would have saved him time. Friday night to Sunday night, the 48-hour race, TBO's at FE1 from Bay Club.
Surely. It's probably gonna be more successful than the 48-hour race at Navarra in March, which is on the same week in the Sebring, which means no one will watch it, as I've already mentioned earlier.
How are these cars side by side through here?
No idea, but seeing the penalty is concerning.
Is he braking? He's braking down the straightaway, actually. Just let him by. Interesting.
Probably not too concerned about that place. Would rather keep, well, I'm a lead. I'm in the am lead. I'd like to keep my am lead, please.
At the same time, Core Pro number 2 exits the pits. They've had Stig Breeding Program, Gen R Pro, and how do you pronounce it? Exion?
Just Ixion. I'm not Ixion? Even sure what it's meant to mean, or if it's meant to mean anything anymore.
Oh, well, those guys.
I know Pyro's name is some word. Your team's name is some word. Actually means something. I'm sure Ixion means anything in any language, but it is.
Actually, Ixion was a Greek king.
Oh yeah, bad thing. Something like bad ideas.
Okay, guys.
I think our team name should be Esperanto, to be honest.
I guess I'm the 68 guy that drives to, yes, in the pits.
They're speeding in the pit.
So guys, we're going to play a game here.
God, but you don't like it.
No. Alright, now you remember the proposed 48 hours of Firm Bay Club and TBO cars. Okay, now.
Wanna run the whole race on your own? Go ahead.
No. Full race, no... no safety cars, nothing like that, just a straight up race. Try to guess the number of laps that would be completed. You can say it to the nearest 100.
That's a good question.
Over 9,000.
Incorrect. Please try again.
2,000.
Incorrect.
High, low.
Higher.
Let's say
3,500.
5,000, no, too high.
3,500.
3,500, that's the closest so far. A little higher, however.
Don't care anymore.
37.
Close enough, 3,800 laps. If it's 45 seconds per lap, which I think that's a little under the world record, it's 3,840 laps. So I think we should do it. Plus, it's the best combo ever. I'm sure plenty would agree. By plenty, I mean like three people.
You, you, and you.
Well, let's just get like 48 people and each person does an hour.
Oh, no, Hellenic lag. Oh, the call!
Oh, but they have another person connecting at the same time. That's interesting. He could have been lagging for a while, so. Wait a minute, that's weird. He changed drivers and then connected right back as he was timing out.
Who knows, maybe he was yelling, can't see any other cars.
It's true.
That's usually quite a sign or tip to yourself. Oh, I can't see anyone.
Guys, we have a huge train of cars, by that I only mean four. Going through the back section currently. There's actually three amateur cars in a row. These are for position, so I just got excited for nothing. Sorry about that, guys. Next closest thing on track is the 66 and the 58. Looking at times, I believe that battle isn't going to happen.
Well, we've already had only many battles that aren't going to happen, or weren't gonna happen.
There's a car facing the wrong way in the final corner.
That is a car.
Martinez again, who's now getting his life through for the chat earlier.
Whoa! He's got the pits as well.
Oh, let me know!
This guy creates excitement, but I don't know if I like that.
Wasn't it CSF who made that Lettery Yellow joke earlier? About...
Yeah.
I was gonna say it again, but I thought, no, I'll leave that as a one-off exclusive.
Is it yellow letters, or...? That's what it should be. Oh, someone else off. The 69 car. And
that
turn
is...
4-ish. Hellenic.
Yes. Bus adventures.
Oh, speaking of Lettorello, his teammate decides to join with the wrong name.
Oh.
Oh.
Last of Robbie rounds. At least to prove a good spirit, but, well. the first time to do this. That's nice.
I think that was a desperate try for both casting and two.
Closing the programs, renaming, looking at where the driver is, pressing T all at once.
Yes.
Oh no!
And
oh my goodness.
Joe. So, if I'm right, that one thing would have been a drive-thru and now with a chat.
But there wasn't a drive-thru for the on-server renaming earlier when it happened.
Okay, so just for the chat.
However, is he coming to pit now? Because if so,
I hope he isn't.
Oh, he shouldn't be, because those tires are plenty thick enough to go an extra lap after doing the drive-thru. He's doing the drive-thru now.
Oh God!
I thought he was gonna go. Well, I thought he was gonna just clout her.
He wanted to.
Oh, and too fast in the pit lane.
Oh dear!
Oh my goodness!
And you need someone to...
Wait, why is he...
You can't pit!
I think he doesn't have enough fuel to do another lap or something.
But he can't pit. Or he can't get any service done. Nothing's happening right now and he's just sitting in the pits.
Yeah, he waits for an admin to...
I'm not sure anyone...
Huh?
But he doesn't have tire change.
I'll get it.
That's an old trick. That's an old sort of trick bug.
57's off again.
That's the second time I've ever seen that happen.
For me, it's a premiere.
I've seen it with a stogger before, which is even weirder. It's very interesting. I wonder whether it is because he got another drive-thru which basically replaced the drive-thru, so he wasn't able to make a pit stop.
No, they don't cancel each other out, if that's what you're trying to say.
Well, it's not like they're adding each other up either. But they are kind of...
Is that 59? The color...
59 was the wrong color.
Yes.
Actually, that's no color exact.
Yeah, I was wondering why it was like a bluish tint. Purple.
Hey, more on server name.
It's early for some of those guys, I guess.
Well, it's 9 o'clock in the morning for him. Well, no, I think it's actually 8 because he's Spanish. No, he just joined. Did he just join the track and spectates? Because that's a problem.
Yeah. It's fine to swap with the dash.
That's not how you swap driver, though.
We can see how or who has stayed up all night and who hasn't.
Yes.
I think I've seen Kagash like in the night hours, to be honest.
That doesn't mean that Lago, or however he's called, didn't stay up.
He lives in the past, because in GMT, if I'm not wrong, because he's in Spain.
No, Spain is in CET, but Portugal is in GMT.
For God's sake, bloody time zones.
Just wondering here, do you guys have anything called Lego waffles?
What?
No.
You don't? Okay. Well, anybody in North America would know what I'm talking about, but never mind.
Lego my egg.
Exactly.
But Lego waffles.
They are Ego waffles. EGDO.
Oh.
But I've always heard like people just call them Lego waffles just for fun.
Well, one of their slogans is Lego my egg.
Exactly.
That is not a very good slogan.
It's an amazing slogan. You ever built a waffle? I mean, that's practically what you're doing here. You just make up the waffles and then you stack them up all nice and neat. You eat them.
I'm not sure the thought of building waffles is any more exciting than this race is right now.
You need something to talk about. I mean, the 21 and the 10, they're just going back and forth. Hey, I'll take a faster lap this lap. No, I will this lap. I'll give it to me this time. You know, they're just going back and forth.
That's just pro, you know.
By the way, for your idea, Phil, I guess he's got one supporter already.
Well,
got a supporter?
Start.
DWB.
Oh, Ben, yeah, Ben would do it. I mean, Ben wanted me to do the...
I like his late comment, I gotta say.
I can't see the comments currently. I haven't loaded that up yet. But me and Ben were actually going to do... What was it? Not the 16-hour race. We were going to do some race together. And we were basically doing like 10 hours each or something crazy like that. But we were going to do 10 hours straight each. Stupidest idea ever, but we would have done it. And then we'd have somebody else fill in the last little role. But I don't remember what the race actually was. Do you guys know?
No idea. It must be some 24-hour race.
Probably ITCC.
ITCC, let's not get crazy. Be realistic here.
And maybe you were talking about 8 hour stints.
Ben says it was the alternate 24-hour race.
Yes.
Ah.
Possibly that. Yes, that sounds very familiar.
I think alternates are hard at building PCs, right? And hosting 24-hour races. I think that's significantly better at building PCs.
Dare you?
Well, I remember last year's alternate.
Oh, 21 mistake! And Hydrogen drives by cleanly.
Last year's alternate 24 hours was rather poorly in terms of.
An attendance. The GT2 class was okay, but.
The NGT.
Was okay, but it was incredibly unbalanced.
Yes.
Don't mean like this unbalance we have here. I mean, unbalanced, unbalanced, unbalanced.
Though I must say the way of the presentation was rather interesting. I mean, the third of the
stream?
The third of the picture was covered with the webcam showing the commentators.
Hey, that could be fun in the middle of the night.
Yeah, especially since you saw the alternate guys in the background celebrating themselves.
We're celebrating ninth place, wherever they were. I don't even remember.
It was there is actually an esports headquarter from alternate.
An esports what?
Headquarter, that's where they invite their esports teams for important leagues and stuff. Like, if their Counter-Strike team makes it into the some final of some important online league, they all gather there and play together.
Third place. Mind Factory. Are they playing mind games with us by any chance? They've just exited the pits, switching drivers.
By the way, in this context, just to complete this, I can really, really suggest you to watch the alternate female Counter-Strike team get ranked. Because they stream such things also.
Interesting.
Yeah.
It's See, now I'm completely confused. The 21 goes off track, hands Hydraman fourth place, and then, you know, you think nothing really of it, and then suddenly they run faster the next lap with a horrible entry speed, or, you know, exit speed of the final corner of the lap before.
Not really, because the main bit that matters is that last bit of the chicane, and they were on the road on that bit.
Barely.
Well, still barely is on the road, so there you go. It was you, you would say, yeah, I would vote. Well, not that in, not in voice, but you would say it.
No, no.
I'm pretty sure.
Soon and then getting a little horn happy.
He's still very horn happy. I noticed that earlier when he was driving. Don't run up his back. God.
Is about 12 hour race with FOA on PY1.
Now, this has been brought up since 2009, originally with IGTC, and then MOE. MOE, people who know that one, had the LMP testing. But IGTC before that, was basically they were just going to use an FO8, and then that was going to be your LMP2, because they all it is just an LMP2 engine, if you think about it. 450 horsepower, etc. And yeah, so you just have FO8 and GT1, let's say. You have yourself a little endurance race.
Yeah, that's actually what Elephants Columbia does.
Yes. Pretty decent idea.
Yeah, also, the way they do it is pretty decent. They, you can find the full races on YouTube somewhere without commentary, but they developed actually all the stuff on their own. So they have got own safety car programs and stuff. And they even have a ticket bar programmed by with what little speed delivers. So in a button system.
Yeah, I remember I got some PMs from them when I was streaming GT2 World Series. They were asking about it. They had quite a bit of stuff lined up rather well. Oh, 58 main straightaway. I don't see any contact or any problems. Never mind. I was lied to.
I wonder when Sunan gets around TRR, which is now. Post callers at least. No, not at least. They are 3 laps ahead. If track is right.
second place, Pitts.
And stays in the car because no one joined. The Rati with whom you had an interview earlier today.
Yeah, the car in third, 15 car, Mind Factory. They actually were within 9 seconds or so of the Virus Pro car. Sometime last stint, but it looks like after that pit stop and everything, Miro stretched it quite a bit. Well, it looks like the 21's made yet another mistake. He's dropped even farther back from Robin Hydrogen.
Well, yeah, he's a bit of a slow split time. Not a massive loss of time, but just maybe a bit a small off in sector one. Bit of a bad turn nine. Never know.
Huh. The 58. Now, we should take a little look-see at this one. In some contact with Tomek Nozjak. On the front straightaway, main straight, pit straight, whatever you guys want to call it. And suddenly he has massive left rear damage.
58?
Yes, the 58.
Yeah, oh, you mean cosmetically? Yeah. Yes. I see that.
Oh, the 21's
suspension. It's totally fine.
Yes. The 21 car is pits.
Oh god! Oh, he's ran up the back of Martinez. Honking in displeasure there. Censoring
just getting,
his own wares.
He's just getting a little horny as well. It's fine.
He's around now. At least he's not gonna do that again until he passes 72 again, but obviously. A long time no see. Hutchinson joins for Vortex to take over from
Pitkinen,
yes. I almost said we have to serve on this server. Seb Hutchinson's gonna take over from Seb Hutchinson, and I was very confused for a second.
Wow, Vortex is an 8th! I just realized that.
Is there an 8th? It's amazing.
Yeah. I mean, they have been dead last.
They were dead last.
Like, 2 laps behind everyone from the Pro class.
But the question could be passed by Conquest, actually, because
They have passed Conquest, from what I see.
Well, no. I mean, Conquest might pass them.
Ah, other way around, yeah.
Oh, Conquest is currently on the front straightaway.
Oh, wait,
both of the Conquest cars.
Close to the end of the stint. Tomek's close to the end of the stint, so... Maybe not.
Actually, let's let Conquest get a little picture here. Both their cars are close.
They had a massive sponsor, they'd get massive coverage right now. They don't.
And then they can give me a share, since I
Phil, dream on.
So the Conquest livery might be the one that changed the leads in this grid. I mean, we've been talking with our dear Chris Ford about that. He was a bit confused.
I don't know what he was talking about, because I don't see any of the skins that have changed massively.
Well, the Inex skin changed quite a bit.
Well, that's the same skin, but with different bits on
it. Literally, white is black is white.
And the our skin is also the same, but black and gold, which is obviously based on a Lotus of Elio De Angelis and not Senna.
Catch the 22 now. He's entering the pits.
You wanna know a very nice fact about the 22 car, or the skin off it?
It was made in less than 30 minutes.
Maybe not that, I doubt that very much, to be honest. No, you need to make by Gertrude, but... it was made after the 500 server shut down, and it's got lots of 500 server logos on it because Gertrude didn't know 500 servers no longer existed.
I had no idea they no longer existed. When did that happen?
Officially, it seems halfway through January.
Interesting. I see a future battle unfolding. Do you have it's somewhere within the top 7 cars? So that
I got a battle of the top 7 cars. I'm sure they're all bumper to bumper.
I see a featured battle this stint between the 07 and the 21. Oh, and also the 54 and 06 are 0.05 apart. Probably should go to them. Don't know when that happened.
Looks like a bit more than 0.05. Well, 0.5. 0.05. Well,
the tracker's lying to me.
Dude, it's just messing with him.
No, it's lying to me. I see the numbers right there. Similar splits.
It's been a theme as well. I don't know. People seemingly in battles doing seemingly equal splits and lap times. And just forever being exciting because they're really very close to each other.
I just want to see a cool battle.
By timing off the Akin Conquest FZR. This is a very fast lap.
Well, it is the best lap, so. Must be a fast lap.
Not really. If you look at F1, for example, their fastest laps are usually like god awful.
But this isn't F1, Dom. This is GT1 World Series.
Technically, you could say it's JGTC World Series. These aren't really GTs.
Oh. We need some Super GT.
You mean DTM in Japanese?
No, Super GT.
It's the same thing though.
DTM and GT3 is all together.
Do DTM cars have carbon fiber brakes?
Uh,
So I know the GT500 isn't allowed to have them, they have steam discs.
By the rules.
I was clearly meaning the LFS League Super GT, by the way.
I don't like those races, are too short, sorry.
Ah, that's what made them exciting, though.
I think that they have carbon super hybrids. Because they needed to cool down their brakes in some races.
Ooh, and they're great different chassis, which are all the same kind anyways, because they're made by DeLorean, just nailed different batches to them.
Maybe the Japanese, like some other people doing that, DeLorean.
I think they're doing them themselves. I think the manufacturers do it themselves, actually.
Yeah, but since Formula Nippon is now also DeLorean.
You mean the Japan Championship Super Formula?
Right.
Which is the best name in the world, because abbreviated, it's JCSF. Wish I had mentioned that earlier.
You mean when CSM was here?
Yes, the Japan CSM. Versus CSF. What CSF thinks about CSF?
This is pretty crazy. 54 and the 06 are running pretty close in times. They're trading splits. Did you say a force field?
I was talking about field, yes.
Force field between Stig Breeding Program and Team Rock Racing? It's interesting.
Yes, very much so. That's what I said before.
What's that field, Diaz?
I have no idea, Joe Lotterello.
Well, how's it going there, Cody? It's nice to be joining us here in the recovery group.
Nice of you to get a drive through for us. What was that about?
That hurt, man.
What was that about?
I think he hit the button, you know, and it made a message, and that caused the drive through.
Yes, but I don't even know why the fuck I was going for the one button, anyways. There's nothing over there. And now I just deleted this bind, so I'm okay now. But
there's so many buttons, you chose that one.
And then I went in for the pit. I didn't know you couldn't pit when you had a drive-through. So I go and pit, and I'm sitting there. I'm like, doo-doo-doo. And then it's like, pit stop finished. I'm like, what? Ah, shit.
See, that's... you can't do that.
Well, you weren't here to update. You said you were going to be here to rub back, but... We were doing very well. I believe me and Tommy caught the Stig Breeding Program farm animals. We caught them like 2 or 3 hours ago pretty decently, and we had like a minute gap over then. Did that happen? I ruined it.
Minute gap, you mean in front of them? Because right now
yes.
You're directly behind them.
Yes, I know.
Your driver, instead of going faster, is just matching his times. 200ths of a second off that last lap.
Yes, he just woke up.
Meaning that last lap.
And my dad and neighbor were watching porn out in the living room, so I was lagging there at the end of the stint. So I wanted to get out of the car.
Doing donuts in the Boothy Chicane.
Which car's doing donuts in the Boothy Chicane?
Gisella. He's not actually doing donuts, but he did spin the car back around. Okay, what else is going on here? Who else are close on track? Has the 07 caught up yet? Doesn't look like it.
Doesn't really look like it.
But he will. He will. Don't worry. Have faith.
Yeah, but it'll take.
Oh, and Joe, can you believe this? You ready for this?
Yes, go for it.
Nobody in Europe knows what Eggo waffles are. Isn't that amazing?
That's not amazing. They're missing out.
It's just... oh.
See, now we know why Europeans are skinny and we're fat, because I used to eat a whole box of Eggos before school.
Oh, I never did that, but okay. Not a whole box.
Might be a little exaggeration, but...
Nikki had a little bit of lag for me. He's still lagging a bit for me.
Lagging.
Yeah, he's all over the place behind Miro.
That's because
really,
he is lagging.
I really hope he doesn't try to pass Miro. Oh, he's lagging out, for sure. Oh, he's back.
He seems to have adopted James Peace's connection from 2 weeks ago in GT1 Challenge. He was doing exactly the same thing. Only the advantage of James Peace was he was in the lead.
Oh man.
Oh god.
Bad part is he's catching Miro. If Miro was smart, he'd just almost just move out of the way for him. That sounds crazy, but...
It's gonna be hard to move out of the way of a car you don't see.
Geez. Well, he had a straightaway to do it. This is getting crazy, I can't watch it.
Problem is, though, if Nicky is lagging like that to us, everyone else is gonna lag like that to him. That's not gonna improve situations, the situation either. Keep thinking he's gonna crash, I don't even know why, because it's not like I don't know he's lagging.
Well, I mean, if anyone's ever excited to watch Nikki crash, this is a good time to watch him, because it looks like his car's crashing every 5 seconds.
Yes, you make a YouTube compilation out of that. It seems like it's normalized now. Actually, I think I've jinxed it.
So far, so good.
His UGP is... it's okay. Oh, no, now it's back.
Yeah, it's back.
A one foul thing, that takes something. Not, that's not even something Australians do at normal rate. But that lag's been there, wait.
Oh, you just slammed the wall for me. I guess he's just gonna drive right behind Mira until
someone's
it cools
just
off.
Chewing his internet line because it's, he didn't have problems like this before, and I don't know him for having problems like this.
It's clearly a squirrel.
It's a squirrel somewhere, chewing on his internet line. Oh my god.
He also caught up another 7/10 of a second on the stick breeding program.
I remember when Eurosport was at the 24 hours of Spa, they always said there's a promise that. A chip store on their internet line.
Because it's been fried.
Now, Tamiro, if he's looking in the rearview mirror and sees that, that has to be the most annoying thing on the history of this Earth. Or at least in LFS.
I mean,
because when you're going for a braking point, you see a car flying at you, then suddenly appears back. He's actually... I think he slowed down and got away from him. Like, intentionally, it looked like. Seconds at a time is not good. can't say that you don't get a warning. Going back to the other stick breeders. They're still holding the gap to Team Rock Racing. Oh, and just so you know, Ben Keough, I am not obsessed with Eggo waffles. I was just being a highly dramatic just to try to spice things up currently.
I agree with the last message, though. That Belgian waffle are very good. Don't eat them very often.
Bloody waffles.
Do you like blue waffles?
What?
I like blueberry ones.
Right. Alright, so what's going on in this race, guys? Probably talk about that.
Well, from my observation here, we got a few cars going on the track. Seems that they hit the accelerator.
A few cars parking pit-lane, not looking very interesting.
They are all evenly spaced out.
I'm being asked about, blue oysters now.
I will Google that.
Oh dear God.
Subs something. Guys, what did Sub do?
Oh, I'm not sure.
I think we can tell exactly what he did. Look at the left front of his car.
I think he updated his aero package.
Yeah, I think the bridge turn he might have ran a
he's
bit
got
wide
tow damage
on exit.
He's got tow damage as well on the left front.
Oh, that's... No, he doesn't. Oh, that's so small.
I think I'm pretty much as before and repaired it.
Yeah, but... They might have just probably had time, I guess.
Tow damage isn't really one of the greatest things.
I had it at West Hill. I thought it was great. Car turned in great. Then I fixed it and I drove a lot faster, but at the same time... Damage wasn't too bad. It's fun to drive.
Oh, I hate damage. Damage is bad. Damage and Pirelli tire.
See, Simon always used to be like that. Simon Cattell, that is. He was one of those ones, if there was like a pixel of damage, we have to repair because it's going to ruin the car's handling. And we always joked about that. But then for West Hill, I had damage that like filled up half the screen, and my right front was caved into the car. And he said, "Don't repair damage." And it was really shocking, actually. Car drove okay though. Didn't blow a tire.
Sorry.
Thank you.
But everything worked out for you, Phil.
How'd it work out for you, Joe?
I hit the smiley button, face button, and I cried.
So you like smiley face buttons?
Oh, by the way, Joe, how is the Blue Oysters on Google?
All I found was blue oysters in a band.
I mean,
like straight up blue oysters, and then like an 80s hair band.
Did you expect something else?
I was expecting something else, yes.
Oh, that's blue waffles.
That's
what you think. And I don't suggest anyone watch that or go to that. So. Ben is talking about Blue Oyster Cult, and he used a highly provocative word, retards, to express his anger toward us.
That's completely different to what you. I have nothing to do with Blue Oysters.
So the 80s hair band.
Or waffles. Blue.
By the way, I'm listening to the live stream of Kevin Loy. There might be a problem for Green Angus Racing. One
Which
of the
way?
Drivers didn't respond, and currently Troy is over the 33% limit win.
Oh dear.
It'll be okay.
It's still 6 hours. Oh my god, we're almost in the stage where there are only 6 hours left! 6 hours, right?
There's always time for a red flag.
No, Joe, you're driving.
What?
Don't call the yellow flag. The red one.
I think if we loaded up a death rally layout right now.
Death rally layouts aren't that good anyways, because frankly, they would be better with the old barrier physics.
He'll
climb up.
Highly disagree on that matter. By the way, Nikki
the old
is catching.
Funny.
Mira Rowdy's
Nikki?
Catching.
Mickey.
Listen.
Nikki's
Mira Rowdy.
Time out.
Yes, Nikki is trying his best. He's trying his best to time out, but the server just won't let him.
Just really amazing to see you.
Reminds me of Sean Litton earlier.
Miro Rowdy, Nikki's gave Miro some space, and Miro's catching the 21 now because of it. And then Nikki's just following in Miro's footsteps, and he's catching the 21. So, yeah, I don't know what's gonna happen here. I'm guessing the 21's gonna let Miro by, and then suddenly Nikki's going to touch him. We're gonna have a huge crash and then a red flag. That's what it looks like.
No, that's a good observation there, Phil. Good one. I like that. I agree.
I think Phil's wrong because he's Phil.
No, he's American. He's right.
And then since it's a red flag, there are said to be no wave arounds under yellow flag. But since there's
True.
A red flag, now everyone just gets their lap back.
Right, we're gonna have to rework the whole system. I agree.
Yeah, exactly.
We should just cancel the race.
Just restart it.
Yeah, just slash restart.
Yeah.
Remember
round
hard.
One, we'll just restart.
Oh yeah, if all the drivers just shift hard right now. Oh man.
I remember there were discussions during some City League races last season where everyone was like, what if we all go like, what if someone says car game ? We all leave and join there.
Now look at
best end of 24 hour race ever.
Look at Ivanov and the core car here.
The one has to admit that partly the races on Grid 1 in City League were very contact intense. From what I saw.
The City League, right?
It's Nikki.
Nikki's trying.
Nah, he's gonna go come back. I can't even worry about his lag crashes anymore because frankly, they don't happen. They happen to us, but they're not happening to him. It probably is very interesting for him to watch everyone else crash all over the place as well.
Well, clearly someone's telling him, or at least he understands what's going on because he's giving room to the cars ahead of him. But I don't know, as soon as Miro passes the 21, I think he's gonna kinda go for it.
first Adana can be written in virtual racing.
I think that's probably something we can be very happy about, that doesn't happen in real life racing with mad crashes. Otherwise there would probably be even fewer Ferraris at Le Mans each year. Actually, I've got to say there are a lot for this year. He's hit Miro off just there. You're pretty convinced he's hit Miro off there.
If he didn't hit him off, he scared him off, that's for sure.
He lagged him off. Ghosted him off. Not sure what you call it. His internet hit him off. Miro's been punished by the internet.
I mean, I think Mickey just has a force field around his car currently, which is just throwing people out of his way.
He has the force.
Yes. I mean, look at that car. I mean, he's practically Darth Vader right now with all the black on his car. So, you never know. I believe you're just speaking about Ferrari and Le Mans. And if we remember last year, a Ferrari driver launched a Toyota.
And no, Anthony David launched himself on a Ferrari.
Whatever you want to say. Basically, a Toyota flew through the air. Well,
yes, and then
our
and
last
then
connection.
Out.
Our last connection. The guy's username is Toyota.
So you're saying he's going to flip and break his back?
Oh, no, he's not Anthony Davidson, but I mean, something spectacular could happen right now because of it. Oh!
Also, that awesome, he can kick fuck get out of his room because of the KERS, not KERS, hybrid system.
True, he needs to wait. Bits. He needs to wait until the hybrid system cools down.
As well, technology have a very good way to turn a hybrid system off efficiently.
Yeah.
By just letting it burn down.
The Glickenhausen Ferrari P4/5 Competizione.
Not really a Ferrari.
It is. It has what is it called? It is a drivetrain from Ferrari.
Doesn't make it a Ferrari.
As per the papers, it is.
God's sake.
Actually, there's rumors that this car, not this car, but that Glickenhausen might enter a P4/5 Competizione for the 24 Hours of Le Mans in 2014.
Lol.
Again with hybrid.
So, we have another little guest slash possible future commentator slash real life racing driver, Dennis Lynn.
Good morning.
Hello.
Did you just wake by any chance and notice your car wasn't on a track anymore?
I woke up and I looked at my phone and it was 8 a.m. and I thought, okay, I'll just stretch it to 9 or something because I was just scheduled to get into the car about 10. Then I went to TeamSpeak and I saw there was no one there. So I started up the tracking and there was no one there. So I guess some meteor hit Hungary and all of them are dead.
I'm checking you, but you can still rejoin.
Nah, 88 laps behind.
It was only a timer. Wouldn't you rather get to at least 75% so you can actually get some points?
Where's the points for completing?
If he finished dead last.
I'm gonna finish second to last, realistically. And I'm gonna finish.
I think you're gonna get 5 points or something in the position you're in at the moment.
Not worth
it. It's better than zero.
Yes, but it's my birthday and I just got up and I don't feel like running.
I should know you're gonna get 10 to the top of points around.
That's a good point right there.
Hi, Joe.
Hello, Dennis Lynn. How are you doing today? Thank you for joining us in the film group.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, happy birthday. Technically it is the 3rd of February.
How old do you know? 12?
120 minus 100.
That's
why you so old?
What?
Why you so old?
Yeah, it's weird. I turned into a man during my stint. I could really feel it.
We're all getting old.
I think I've got some gray hairs just from sitting through the first 18 hours of this race.
But it hasn't been too bad. Was there any cautions while I was in bed?
There's possibly going it's to be one here if Nikki more. Keeps lagging.
I think you should run next year on Sunday, so a bit more, you know, safety car action.
I'm even sure I still want to actually, you know, I just want it to end.
Yeah, you've been awake for the whole time, haven't you, Dominic?
Yeah, yes, well, I have been awake for the whole race, but then I only got up like 1 hour 45 before the start.
Well, I got up 30 minutes before the race, and I was quite scared because I was sleeping in, apparently. And it's Phil's fault.
Yeah, Phil.
What? I never did anything.
You dragged me into the R-Factor 2 thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
you did. Oh, really?
Make me download a lot of crap and...
Hey, let's calm down now. Back to the action on the track here, ladies and gentlemen. Cars are still going around the track here, not missing much. It's a quite boring race at the moment. Back to you, Dennis Lynn.
But that's the unpredictability of lag at the moment. That's the biggest thing right now.
Dennis, your voice has changed, but thank you.
I'm here.
No. We were simply driving the new Corvette GT2 car. R-Factor 2 on Sebring.
No, we were doing Lift for Speed beta testing.
Yes.
Well, no, shut up. You can't tell people that.
Oh, that's right.
What do you make of it?
Oh, we can't tell you, and we're not going to tell you. If you mean the R-Factor 2...
I'm talking of the Corvette.
That's actually quite intriguing. I kind of enjoy
it's quite good from before.
Yeah. You could feel the car pretty good, actually. There's quite a bit of fun around
it's very loud.
I couldn't hear you speak. I found that a good thing.
They improved the sound, which was pretty bad.
Yeah, I'd rather listen to that car than many other cars and other simulators.
I'd rather listen to that car than Phil.
Like I said, I couldn't hear TeamSpeak. couldn't even hear myself talk.
And he couldn't even hear himself concentrate because he was quite slow.
And we know Phil likes to hear himself talk.
All the time. I actually have an echo thing, so I hear myself talk all the time.
You probably have the stream on. Four of them.
Four, yeah, exactly.
I don't want to interrupt you, but we need to cut the stream into a nice little piece.
I'm sorry, we're not talking about anything.
So, we are returning in a few seconds.